6 intensity, best heard at the right, second intercostal space, radiation to both the capsids and as well as to the apex. This is harsh frequency, mixed frequency murmur, crescendo decrescendo, long and late peaking murmur. This murmur is best heard with diaphragm of the stethoscope and in leaning forward position during expiration. Intensity of the murmur.
You don't have to tell that when the murmur is already loud, all this bending forward expiration, that is pick up a soft murmur. Okay, it's already grade 4 murmur.
Dynamic. Would I tell madam dynamic oscillation?
No. It's already loud murmur, no?
Okay.
It's already grade 4 murmur. Yes. Long, loud, late peaking. See, you said something about frequency. What is frequency and what is pitch?
Mixed frequency, madam.
No, what do you mean by frequency? What do you mean by pitch? Same, you use interchangeably, right?
Yes, madam. Frequency equals to pitch. Yes.
Frequency is what is recorded. Pitch is what is heard. Okay. What you hear is, you express as pitch. Frequency is recorded. So what determines this frequency of a murmur?
Gradient, madam. Gradient across the wall.
Well, is it directly related or inversely related? When the gradient increases?
When the gradient increases, like in aortic stenosis, the intensity of this frequency also increases. So directly relation is there, madam.
Okay. Gradient increases, frequency increases. Why it is... medium frequency here. What else determines the frequency? One is the gradient, other is the volume of flow.
Volume
increases, the whole blood has to go through the aortic valve, right? So when the volume flow increases, the frequency decreases.
Okay.
So it's inversely related there. So this thrill, when do you feel the thrill? Low frequency or high frequency?
Frequency.
Low frequency. Thrill is felt when it is low frequency or medium frequency. Okay. High frequency murmurs like AR, you know, generally get thrilling. So, mixed frequency or low frequency. Like in MDM of MS.
Yes, ma'am.
Thrill is more common.
Yes.
That is low frequency. Whereas MR, thrill is less common because it is high frequency. When there is severe MR, you may get a thrill because the flow increases. So the frequency decreases. So you get medium frequency. Then you may feel the thrill. These two things you should remember. The frequency is affected by
gradient.
Flow as gradient. Gradient is directly related, flow is inversely related.
Okay.
Then the intensity and thrill depends on the frequency.
Yes,
sir. Frequency, high frequency, unlikely to get a thrill.
Yes.
Okay.
And MR is a high frequency murmur.
MR is high frequency, but because the gradient is high, but when the volume of flow is more, that means VMR, we get medium frequency. That is when you get thrill. That is why they said thrill and the intensity can be related to the severe, especially in rheumatic MR, not in ischemic and other MRs.
Okay. Yes, the flow will decrease now.
Yes, when flow decreases, thanks for the murmur. Flow decreases when there is aortic stenosis. So then the murmur intensity comes down.
Yes. Frequency, madam?
Flow, all the flow has to go through the aortic valve, right?
Yes, ma'am.
What happens to the frequency when in the apex phase, murmur? Hear anything?
High frequency sounds get easily heard, madam, at apex, musical components.
So which type of aortic stenosis it is heard?
Volumular aortic stenosis, madam.
Correct. Calcified aortic valve, because calcified air, well, there is no fusion, it just thickens and calcified, so it can vibrate to certain extent, and then high frequency of that is heard in the apex.
The apex.
Yeah, in dromatic, galavaridins, whatever you say, it is not, see, galavaridin is not just the murmur heard in the apex, it is the high frequency components of the murmur heard in the apex, which can be mistaken for MR.
MR.
So that happens in calcified aortic valve.
Yes, ma'am. Other system examinations, madam, normal. CNS respiratory system and per abdomen are normal. Final diagnosis. Situs solitus, levocardia, acquired valvular heart disease, mostly degenerative etiology, severe aortic stenosis, without evidence of congestive cardiac failure or infective endocarditis, with mild pulmonary venous hypertension and mild pH, and the patient is in normal sinus rhythm, now in NYHA class 2.
Okay, no precipitating factors.
No precipitating factors.
How did you say it? What are the points here to say that it is severe aortic stenosis?
Starting from his pulse, madam. Narrow pulse.
Maybe symptoms also you can include. Insertional syncope.
Yes, start from symptoms. He is having dyspnea, syncope. Then this is narrow pulse pressure with low volume, slow rising, leg picking pulse with carotid trill and
palpable. Severity.
Yes, sir. With palpable and apico-carotid delay.
One is pulse, you said, correct. Then yeah, apico-carotid delay, correct. Then
palpable S4, madam. Palpable S4.
S4, heaving epic impulse.
Heaving epic impulse. S2, single S2. And loud and late picking. Ejection systolic.
Okay.
ECG.
Anything else?
No. Investigation. Nikhil, can you please put ECG in this?
So, what do you expect in the ECG?
Because of the pressure over states, I will expect the ECG will be having left ventricular hypertrophy with a strain pattern, madam.
Strain pattern means what?
Strain pattern means, madam, T wave inversion, ST and ST T wave inversion only in the lateral leads V5, V6, and also in the wave.
So there will be absence of Q waves.
Septal, loss of septal Q waves will be there. Loss of septal Q waves.
So V5, V6, normally you get a small Q wave which disappears in
and
pressure over. Yeah, then ST depression with asymmetric T inversion.
Q wave inversion.
You get any other chamber enlargement you expect here?
LA enlargement is one of the sensitive signs for this.
LA maybe. Which is the most sensitive ECG finding for LA?
LA, yes, madam.
Yeah? Which is the most sensitive ECG finding for left atrial enlargement?
Terminal, in V1, terminal P wave 0.04 millisecond, madam. Morris index positive.
Morris index, which is the most specific?
Interpeak distance.
Macro's index. Macro's index.
Interpeak distance.
Macro's index.
Macro's illa. Interpeak distance more than 40 milliseconds. So read the ECG.
Yes, madam. This is 12-lead ECG with normal standardization. Rate is around 75 per minute regular and the normal sinus rhythm. Axis is 45 degree. This are normal. Slight PR prolongation there, madam, to 105 milliseconds. By Sokolo and Lyon voltage criteria, that is S wave in V1 and R wave in V5, more than 35 millimeter with T wave inversion in 1 AVL and V5 V6. Suggest of left ventricular hypertrophy with strain pattern.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
QRS axis.
QRS axis is 45 degrees.
Normal. Okay. No,
no.
Good.
Chest X. Dr. Nikhil.
What is the single lead criteria for LVH?
This RVO will reveal more than as per Sokolo Land criteria.
What is Cornell voltage criteria?
Cornell voltage criteria is different for male and female. In male, RVO in AVL and SVO in BC more than 28, or R in AVL plus SV3 more than 20 in females. That is of different will happen.
Very classical.
This is a chest X-ray, PA view. Gastric fundus is seen on the left side. So that is cardia. CT ratio is 0.4. No cardiogel is there.
You should say some other things also, no? You said AV view. PA view, then not X.
Penetration, madam, more than 4 interval spaces in this.
Position of the patient.
Scoliosis is there, sir.
Should be some scoliosis.
No, that is trachea. That is trachea. Scoliosis. Trachea shows my left side indentation suggestive of left aortic arch. From aortic knuckle is present. So on the right side, ascending aorta seems to be dilated, man.
Integration?
I call, man. 0.4 stroke cardiomegaly is there.
But what is the striking feature on the left border?
A prominent aortic knuckle, madam.
What happens classically, you don't get cardiomegaly, but you get a rounded contour there. Yeah. There is no LA, no pulmonary. No. There is no pulmonary venous hypertension, huh?
Yeah. Yes, madam. Slide, you can see.
Okay. Ascending aorta is very prominent.
Yes, ma'am.
How do you differentiate X-ray of AS from AR?
In AR we'll have cardiomegaly, and in AS we'll have this postural rotation will be there. And sorry, madam. Hello.
Sorry?
Yeah,
AR do you get aortic dilatation or not?
Yeah, we can get, madam, in AR also, but
even arch gets dilated in AR.
Yes, madam. Post aortic dilatation
in AR? Yes, you get ascending aortic dilatation in AR. Even the arch gets dilated because more blood is going, no?
Then cardiac will be present in the aortic regurgitation, madam.
That is very striking.
Prominent aortic
knuckle. Here ascending aorta is dilated.
Yeah.
I have told you.
He told that it's prominent, isn't it? You have to look for especially.
And also, madam, valvular calcification will be present in case of aortic stenosis. In this patient, I tried but not seen in this PA view.
It's difficult. You have to do a fluoroscopy for that.
Where
do you look for the aortic calcification?
In chest X-ray PA view, we draw a line from right cardiophrenic angle to the pulmonary vein. And if this
left hilum.
Left hilum. And if...
The pain doesn't increase slowly when it is concave in patients with... increase pulmonary blood flow like TOF. You say left hilum.
Left hilum, sorry. So if calcification or prosthesis, anything is above this line, suggest of aortic wall, and if it is below, the suggest of mitral wall. In lateral X-ray, lateral chest X-ray, we draw a line from apex to the hilum, and if on this line, on anterior and middle third, tricuspid wall prosthesis or tricuspid calcification can be seen if it is and anterior to this line will be aortic wall and posterior to the line will be the mitral wall.
you do lateral X-rays regularly or just theoretically, you say?
No, madam, not regularly. It's our kid don't do it.
Some exam they keep lateral X-rays, so then you'll be in trouble. Better you know about something about lateral X-rays. Okay, do you have anything else?
Photography report I am having, madam. Aortic wall velocity across the aortic wall maximum is 4.5 meter per second.
First is morphology of the aortic
wall. Madam, it is severely calcified aortic wall. Would not be.
When it is severely calcified, difficult to differentiate. Only on the table, surgeon should be able to tell us whether it's like this or not. See, bicuspid aortic valve, even after aortic valve replacement, they can get aortic adhesion. So you have to follow them up. That is the significance of knowing whether it's bicuspid or bicuspid.
Yes, sir. Aortic wall peak binding gradient is 81/50 millimeters of mercury. Aortic wall area calculated by continuity equation 0.9 centimeter square, so it's two of severe aortic symptoms. And indexed aortic wall area is 0.5 centimeter square per meter square. Left ventricular ejection fraction is 60%, madam. And we have GLS also minus 15.
No, I want something more about your. You said how do you explain this dyspnea? LV function is 60% normal. So how do you explain this? Yeah.
LV diastolic dysfunction can also cause, madam.
We look for that.
Type 3 diastolic dysfunction. Type 2. Actually, I don't have, madam, exact report, but I remember it was type 2 diastolic dysfunction was moderate.
So was there LV dilatation? It has to be there.
It has to be there.
So what do you want to do now? Severe aortic stenosis, you got it from history itself, then findings confirmed.
Yes.
CG, X-ray, echo, everything is confirmed. Severe aortic stenosis,
yes.
Most probably degenerative.
Aortic stenosis.
As I told you, should look for the aortic root dilatation here. Okay, you should look for the annulus, sinus, and the ascending aortic dilatation. So also look for the coarctation of aorta when you suspect the bicuspid aortic valve.
Yes.
Okay, then what next? Because here X-ray showed extending aortic dilatation. Any mention for the aortic size in the echo?
No, madam. Actually, I am having only 4-5 readings only. I have just written, madam.
So, you should be careful to look for that because X-ray classically showed some extending aortic dilatation. Okay, go ahead. So, what do you want to do next?
Coronary angiogram has already been done, madam. It was
so, what indications for coronary angiogram heart disease? Another classical question.
Patient is having a chest pain, and in patient is more than 40 years age group, and if patient is having risk factors for coronary disease.
Male more than 40 years, female more than female what?
Postmenopausal female.
Postmenopausal age is not same for both.
Yes, madam. Postmenopausal.
So you should go. Going fast express, then risk factors of heart disease, angina, LV dysfunction,
and if
previous coronary heart disease or so. Yeah. Okay. So coronary is normal. Next.
Next
question we'll go for.
We plan for, madam.
What are the indication for surgery?
Surgery. And for wall replacement.
What are the indication for surgery?
Stage B. Hello. Hello.
Indication for surgery.
And the stage D patient, that is severe symptomatic aortic stenosis patient, and we can do for aortic wall replacement when asymptomatic.
Asymptomatic severe, yes. When do you advise surgery?
With LV, LV dysfunction.
EF less than, EF 50% cut off then?
That key, or if asymptomatic severe AS patient with other valvular heart disease, or in case if patient is having coronary disease also, then we can concomitantly do the surgery both.
So if aortic root replacement, then
in that case also.
These are the severe case, so you'll have to replace. Then once this diagnosis is over, all these, your low flow, low gradient, paradoxy, all those things will, you will read up. Those things will be coming to discussion. Then surgical versus TAVI, and then you're all, I think, experts in TAVI. Hmm? Are you doing in your hospital? Is it planned for TAVI or surgical?
Man, this patient was posted 3 months back only. Surgical, SAVAR was done, madam. We don't have a general tower procedure.
Yes, he underwent surgical area or transcutaneous? He already underwent surgery?
Yeah, he already underwent surgery. Surgical aortic wall replacement, SAVAR.
Surgical aortic, okay. Okay, fine. So all those things will be discussed in a patient if you have a long case, okay? Paradoxic low flow, low gradient.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Any questions? Any medical management?
Medical management in the form of diet.
What drug was extensively tried in the patients? Which drug was tried?
Statin.
No role now. Statin. Rosuvastatin. So many trials.
D-cell and S2-MS trial.
Yeah, it did not show any benefit unless there was hypercholesterolemia. Okay, what drugs are contraindicated? Suppose this patient has angina, can you give nitrates?
Nitrates.
Huh?
We can't give, madam.
Generally, beta blockers are contraindicated, vasodilators are contraindicated, most of the drugs are contraindicated. So once they become symptomatic, surgery only. So no EF is a contraindication for AVR.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe you'll have to look for contractile reserve. How do you do that?
There'll be contractile reserve. We calculate the stroke volume index. Stroke volume, if it is more than 20%, suggestive of left ventricle contractile reserve.
With what? Dobutamine?
Dobutamine. Low dose dobutamine basically.
You have to start with dobutamine. Stress. All these things will be discussed. Then. Okay, post-surgery, any drug is shown to, what well you advise for him, surgery?
This is a 66-year-old male, madam, so it's better to bioprosthetic.
Bioprosthetic, yeah. Above 70, always bioprosthetic, between 50 to 70. Either it's bioprosthetic or mechanical prosthesis.
Yes.
Degeneration is less common. Especially in aortic position, so you can use bioprosthetic valve. So any drug can be useful in this situation. How do you manage post surgery?
Anticoagulation, madam.
Mm-hmm.
Anticoagulation will give, madam, warfarin for first 3 months with a INR of 2.5 to 3.5, and as it is bioprosthetic,
2 to 3. Aortic position is 2 to 3, unless they have.
Unless they have any risk factors like...
Risk factors, yeah. Otherwise, he doesn't have risk factors, no? What are the risk factors?
But madam, initially, first 3 months, we will keep an angle of 2.5 to 3.5. After 3 months...
No, position it is 2.5 okay. to 3.5. Aortic position, no risk factor, it is 2 to 3.
Okay, madam. Okay.
Which wall you can have 1.5 to 2 NR?
This wall X
one X. That is only in aortic position. 1.5 to 2, supposed to be less thrombogenic. Okay, so Arun, any role for statin?
Ma'am, it helps in reducing the degeneration of bioprosthetic valves.
Yeah, so this was asked in the last exam actually. Even I didn't know statin. Mm-hmm. Shown to reduce degeneration by prosthetic valves.
Bioprosthetic valves.
Yeah. Yes. Anything else? So you give aspirin now? After that, 3 months?
After
Yeah.
Aspirin will give, madam. This is a bioprosthetic valve, so will not give warfarin. We will continue aspirin only.
Okay, it 6:09 o'clock. Any other doubts or any other question?
Ma'am, one doubt, ma'am. Actually, there is a singular stuff. How to say this loud pitch and pH?
No, the pH of what is going. You decide by something, right?
Ma'am, I couldn't hear you properly.
There is echoing. Maybe we'll discuss some issue. Nikhil?
Yeah, ma'am.
There is some problem, I think. It's echoing.
Yeah, ma'am. What happens if someone has kept their laptop open and mobile also open? Sometimes you get, or sometimes some other device will cause like this echo, ma'am. So, but it is rare.
Yes, ma'am.
He's asking, I think, when to tell, how to tell loud in the presence of single S2.
Yeah.
That is the thing he was asking.
Single, that is a difficult issue. Maybe depending on the intensity, your experience.
Ma'am, but one more doubt, madam.
Ma'am, I tell single S2, I will always tell normal V2 or normal A2. That's all.
If it is heard, if you think it's P2, but it is heard.
If it is very loud and some associated findings, then we can tell.
Yeah, other big paras only, even other things. Maybe by intensity you have to tell, though it is
single with
yeah, but it is just equal to A2, that range may be difficult, but if it is louder, we can. In elderly people, if you hear the P2 itself, it's difficult, no? We may not hear the P2 in elderly people, you may hear only A2. So, if it is, then you have to
give
some judgment. Okay.
Madam, one doubt. Which type of apex will get in MR?
MR?
Sorry, MR, which type of thrill will get, madam? Thrill.
Systolic thrill. You may in rheumatic MR, you can.
Okay.
So that is.
Ma'am, in this case,
he has told left ventricular systolic pressure is about 250 mmHg. So how to say, ma'am, if I'm not heard wrong?
You said that, but. Depends on the systolic pressure plus the gradient. What is this gradient? What is the peak gradient? Hello?
Before you told some values. Anyhow, S4 everything was there, no ma'am. It will be more than.
More than 70 gradient. Blood pressure of 110. It may not be 110. It may be something like 200. 110 plus 70. 180, something like that. Yeah.
Ma'am, that 70 is mean gradient or peak gradient, ma'am, actually?
I think it's peak.
Peak.
Mm-hmm. Usually you say 70 severe is peak.
Mm-hmm. 70 peak.
64?
Yeah. When do you say very serious?
More than 5 meters per second.
More than 5 meters per second velocity according to ACC, and according to EAC more than 5.5 meters per second. And gradient will be more than 60. Peak gradient, the mean gradient will be more than 60.
Okay. So based on the 250, a little too much. In that case. VP of 150, 160 and then gradient of 100. Then maybe it's 250. But there is some book says, Allah. How did you say 250? There is a presenter, Bana.
Dr. Sumit?
Yeah.
I think he has left.
Hello.